How's it going, guys? Bibi here with another anime news. So to start us off, Aniplex of America released the dub cast for the series Charlotte. They announced this at Otakon a few days ago, and they said that Ray Chase, Lauren Linda, Lucien Doge, I'm sorry, I don't know how to say the name of this person, Ryan Bartley and Kieran Buckland are all going to be in this series. Earlier in the year, they announced the Blu-ray release of Volume 1 and Volume 2 for Charlotte. Volume 1 will be coming out very soon on August 16th for $75, and Volume 2 will be coming out in November for also $75. Kyoto Animation Series 3 is going to be getting another project. In this announcement, they didn't mention what type of media this will be. The manga Peach Girl is getting a new series called Peach Girl Next. This will be a continuation from the last Peach Girl, and it will be placed 10 years in the future. Look forward to seeing that in the next issue of Kodokawa's Be Love magazine. The manga Inside Mari is ending in Futabashi's 17th issue, which will be coming out on September 6th. Also to be finishing in September is the light novel How to Raise a Boring Girlfriend. This will be publishing in the next Kodokawa's monthly Dragon Age magazine. The light novel inspired an anime in 2015, and it's going to be getting a sequel in April of 2017. Idea Factory's Nil Arimari no Tenbin will be getting a sequel. Just like its prequel, it's going to be on the PlayStation Vita. They haven't announced when it's coming out or how much it's going to be, so I'll make sure to update you all when I find out more. Now, this is a game I'm really curious about. Idle Death game for the PlayStation Vita. It looks like they're bringing a dark element to the idol genre, which looks very interesting. If you're interested, there is a link down below to the trailer that you can watch. It gave me more questions than answers. This game will be coming out in Japan in October. Xseed Games announced earlier in the week that The Legend of Heroes Trial Cold Steel 2 is getting a Western release. We know that it's releasing in North America on the 6th of September. As for Europe, all we know is that it's coming out this fall. It's going to be on the PlayStation Vita and PlayStation 3. The fan game Pokemon Uranium has been taken down by Nintendo. The game just released 1 week ago, and unfortunately, Nintendo sent a takedown notice, so they had to take it down. But not before 1.5 million people downloaded this game. On the website where Pokemon Uranium's link was, the owners of the site put down a little message for the fans of the game. The link is inactive, unfortunately, so you can't go and download it anymore. But this is what they said on their site. While we have not been personally contacted, it's clear what their wishes are, and we respect these wishes wholeheartedly. It's a shame that they had to take this game down. From what it looks like, they've been working on this game for a very long time, so it's a real blow to them. For the people that have downloaded the game, good on you. It's great that you're supporting fan games. Let me know in the comments below if you have downloaded this game. I'm interested to know. I didn't get to it before it got taken down, unfortunately, so I'm not going to be able to play it. Guardians of the Galaxy and Gravity Fall writers are in talks to work on the new Pokemon live action movie. They say that the production of the movie should start in 2017, and they're going to have the Detective Pikachu character in this movie, apparently. As for the distributors of this movie, Toto is going to be the distributor for Japan, and Universal Pictures is going to distribute the movie outside of Japan. No Game No Life's light novel is continuing. It's on its 9th volume, and this will release on August 25th. And apparently, announced last month, there is going to be an anime movie. We have no extra details as to when this movie will be releasing, or whether they've actually started on this movie. So when I find out more about this, I'll make sure to let you all know. Because I love No Game No Life, I just want a second season. But I'll take a movie. Meanwhile, the Kizu Monogatari film will be getting a US theatrical release. Aniplex of America announced at Otakon that the film will release around the country in October. We have no set dates as to when this film will come out in America other than October, and we don't know what theatres will be getting the movie, so when I find out more about that, I'll make sure to let you all know. As for the movie itself, it is going to be Japanese with English subtitles. On to merchandise news now, and two characters from the School Life series are getting their own figures. These figures are going to be 22 centimetres tall and they're set to come out early 2017. In the last anime news, I talked about Dragon Ball Z's Android 17. Well, now it's Android 18's turn to come out for pre-order. You can find her on AmiAmi's site for 8,856 yen, or about $87. She's 188 centimeters tall, she comes with two faces, and her clothes are made out of material, which is quite different for figures. She also comes with one of the parts for the Minicell Junior figure. As I said in the last news, you have to buy her, Android 17, and Cell if you want to get the full set for the Cell Junior figure, because you put them all together. As for when she's coming out, you can pre-order her now, and she's coming out late October. Now, this is a pillow that I never thought that I'd see. At Comiket, they released a pillow of Monster Musume's Maya's Just the Tip pillow. Yes, you heard me right, the name of it is Just the Tip. As you can see from the picture here, it's a rather large pillow. It's going to be 7,000 yen. Now, I don't know if it was a Comiket exclusive or whether it's releasing and you can buy it somewhere. So, if you do know this, leave it down in the comments below. But only in Japan, man, seriously. And lastly, if you're a fan of Maya, then you might be interested in this 20cm Maya figure for 16,170 yen. She's up for pre-order at the moment. You can find her on AmiAmi's site. I'll make sure to leave a link in the description below if you want to go and find her and pre-order her. If you do, let me know. I think that I might actually pre-order her. She's a little bit pricey, but she looks beautiful. She is a very nice looking figure. And that's all the anime news I have for you today. What was your favourite article? Is there anything that you want to buy? And is there anything that you're looking forward to? Leave it all in the comments below, I'm looking forward to reading them all. While you're there, please make sure to give this video a big like and share it out to all your friends. I'd really appreciate it. And if you haven't already, go have a look at the rest of my channel. Also, I'm on social media. So if you want to chat to me, I'm on Twitter and Facebook. So come like me and follow me on there. And if you want to see more from me and more videos like this, then please make sure to subscribe for a wide range of anime content. From Oe Jameka, thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time. Bye bye!